Next, we discovered a great Michigan success story. It's the story of two guys who took advantage of Michigan's tremendous resources and are now literally enjoying the fruits of their labor. Since its inception in 1981, American Spoon has been using local ingredients to produce some of the finest preserves in the world. And it all began right here in Petoskey. I met up with Justin Rashid at the factory to talk about how it all came to be.
Many years ago, it's been 28 years ago now, I was a wild food forager. And a friend had introduced me to a New York chef who wanted to be the great American chef. So he wanted to use all American ingredients. And I began to supply him first with Michigan morel mushrooms that I picked myself. And he said, what else do you have? And I said, well, what else do I have? I mean,
I'm in Michigan.
You're the fruit capital of the world. And I started to send him wild berries. And then we got to the point where we got more fruit than he could use in his restaurant. And simultaneously, I brought him out here to visit a buffalo farm in Traverse City. And as we were driving down to the buffalo farm, he was being a typical New Yorker. He'd never looked at a map. So as he looked to the right, he kept saying, we've been following this same water for a long time. What is this, a lake or a river? What is this?
I said, well, that's Lake Michigan.
That's called Lake Michigan. It's one of the Great Lakes. He said, how big is it? It's very big. It goes all the way to Chicago. It's 100 miles across. Yeah. And he said, one more question. What are all these trees that I see growing in rows? I said, well,
they're fruit trees.
These are orchards. Those are fruit trees. This is one of the most superb microclimates for fruit culture in the entire world. Those are cherries and apples and pears and plums and apricots. And he said, really? And the very next thing he said was, can you make jam? And I said, well, I grew up with my mother making jam. I'll tell you what, you give me a recipe, I'll find the fruit, and we'll make jam. That's how we set out to make the best preserves in America from Michigan fruit.
Now, you're a Michigan company. You employ a lot of Michigan people. What do you love about doing business in Michigan?
Well, it's my home state. I love Michigan. I think the people, there's always something new to discover here.
An American Spoon is one of those great Michigan discoveries. Next, we got a chance to meet Chris Detmer, a San Francisco transplant and former Iron Chef contestant who now heads up new product development here.
No, I was really excited to meet you, Chris, because I saw you on Iron Chef Battle Oatmeal, and he won.
We won, yes, sir.
That's
very
awesome.
Exciting day.
I thought I recognized you. Anyway, so you're the R&D guy here.
Correct.
So, which is, it must be fun doing research and development on food.
It's just a lot of playing around all day long.
Give me a little bit idea of the quality and what you do.
Well, we try to stay extremely local to northern Michigan. You know, these cranberries for this product here came from Sheboygan, Michigan Cranberry Farm. The apples and the pears in those products came from Frisky Orchard, which is about half an hour south of us.
So what are some of the more outrageous things that you R&D, that you research?
You know, we're a traditional preserve making company, so we can't go nuts.
Right.
You know,
just fruit, no nuts, right? Okay, I get it.
Just fruit, no nuts. But we're still, you know, trying to be creative. Like the cranberry you just tasted. Michigan cranberries, but we're taking these kind of exotic, maybe you would call them Indian spices.
And I kind totally of taste that too.
Hitting it with that. So it's very subtle, but it's you know, creating a local product that has a new flavor profile that you really wouldn't experience elsewhere.
You're like the mad scientist of fruit.
Thank you, sir.
You're doing a good job.
When all was said and done, I bought a couple jars of Michigan cherry raspberry preserves for my wife, Kathy, and she's a gourmet cook, so major points for Tom. Under the Radar Michigan is brought to you in part by the Michigan State Housing Development Authority.